The Philippines reports 5,790 new COVID-19 cases on Sunday. The Department of Health says the six labs were unable to submit data, which may be the reason for the low number of new infections. COVID-19 testing also dipped last week. The total COVID-19 cases in the Philippines is now over 1,143,000. The death toll from the virus rose by 140 on Sunday, as fatalities near the 20,000 mark. The Philippines currently has 55,000 active COVID-19 cases. The number of recoveries, meanwhile, has breached 1 million, with more than 7,500 added to the tally. The healthcare utilization rate in hospitals across Metro Manila shows signs of improvement as COVID-19 cases in the region decline. The Philippine Health Department says 51% of isolation and COVID-19 ward beds are currently occupied, but intensive care unit utilization remains high at 61%, with some hospitals at moderate to critical risk. Still, the agency says the numbers have improved compared to 2 weeks ago.
Nakadelegate tayo or nakakonvert tayo ng mga 384 isolation beds into critical care beds, no? And nag-open din tayo ng ating field modular hospital. May critical status natin sa Metro Manila, nakikita namin sa mga intensive care units, lalong-lalo na sa Makati, Taguig, and Caloocan. Puno ang kanilang intensive care units. Pero yung hospital, sa isolation beds nila, at saka yung COVID wards nila, open sila, nasa 58%. Mataas lang ang kanilang ICU or utilization rate.
The Department of Health reports 10 more cases of the India COVID-19 variant, bringing the country's total to 12. Nine of the cases are Filipino crew members of the MV Athens Bridge, which docked in the country last week after 12 of 21 people aboard the ship tested positive for the virus. Four of them are still hospitalized but in stable condition, while the other five are in an isolation facility. The other new case is also from a seafarer from Belgium who arrived in Manila on April 24 via the United Arab Emirates. The India variant is believed responsible for the record-breaking numbers in the South Asian country and could prove devastating if it were to spread in the Philippines.
Because if this variant will now be is not present in the Philippines, hopefully it will not be causing more cases or what we call community transmission, because it's very difficult again to have another surge and can also strain the function of most of this healthcare facility. There are already evidence that this variant can affect the efficacy of a vaccine, and we need more studies on that. These are the two aspects of variants what we should monitor: the number of cases because of its highly transmissible character, and at the same time how it can impact on those who are vaccinated and still to be vaccinated because of the protection that these vaccines can have against these variants.
The Philippine government last week extended and expanded the travel restrictions on travelers from India until the end of the month to halt the spread of the variant from the country. Travelers from Oman and the United Arab Emirates were also included in the latest travel ban, joining Bangladesh, Pakistan, Nepal, and Sri Lanka. A fire broke out at the Philippine General Hospital on Sunday. As this report tells us, though the fire was contained after just a few hours, it was still a blow to the country's largest COVID-19 referral hospital.
A fire broke out at the third floor of the Philippine General Hospital early Sunday morning. Firefighters had to use breathing apparatus as they struggled to get through the thick smoke.
Kwento lang ng mga guards yan, sila na lang daw may makapal na usok na lumalabas, yung family hallway. Kasi yung room daw nila, yung third floor. So yung linen area, kasama doon sa operating room.
Sir, positive kami sa ano?
The PGH management says the room where the fire started contained linen and blankets, which made it hard to contain. The fire did not spread to other floors, but many areas were still affected by the smoke. Around 500 patients had to be evacuated, including the elderly and newborn babies. Also evacuated were 156 COVID-19 patients, including critical cases, some of whom were still intubated.
Napaka-challenging no, dahil mga naka-intubate. Nailagay po namin sila sa COVID wards po namin muna sa charity dahil ICU setup po, meron po kami doon. They're very aware na hindi mo pwede paghaluin kaya yung flow of patients po, may sistema naman po kasi yung PGH, parang nahati namin yung PGH sa dalawa, sa non-COVID at COVID.
Lahat ay gusto makalabas din sa rooms nila. Sabi yung mga doctors, meron na hindi pa kumalang yung effort nila na evacuate yung mga patients nila. Pero dahil sa maraming patients, so nakatigit-digit na rin sa hallway at saka doon sa labas.
Firefighters admit responding to a fire at a COVID referral hospital is a challenge.
Dapat din kami. Kaya alam namin na yung PGA sa isang COVID hospital. Pero tungkulin nito yun. Kailangan na gawin namin, kapanan namin yung tungkulin namin.
For now, the PGH is not accepting patients at its emergency room, which is being used to house some of the evacuated patients. The hospital is dismayed at the timing because their COVID situation was just becoming more manageable.
Sarado muna po ang emergency room ng PGH kasi po ginamit po naming evacuation center.
12 newborns from the ICU as well as some patients have been temporarily transferred to various hospitals. The fire reached the second alarm before a fire out was declared before 6 in the morning. The cause of the blaze is still being determined. The PGH has called for emergency aid and is accepting food and non-food donations as well as cash. Those interested can also coordinate with their Bayanihan Operations Center at 155-200.